So here's a setup I've been using. I've been using this waterproof, shock-resistant Nikon Coolpix. It's an AW100, but been put that, just taped it with some paper onto the shock mount. I have the 5-megapixel camera for this guy, but put it on that and gonna screw it on, take some video, and add it to this video, and show you what it looks like with using a point-and-shoot camera on there. That it actually holds the weight. I have the strap on the camera and just dangle it and hang it, and I loop the extra. I kind of pull up the slack on the necktie and wrap it around itself so it only hangs, you know, just below, you know, probably 6 inches down or so. And then when I wrap the cord around it and take some of the slack out, because I've flown it with just it hanging and it wobbles a lot, so when I take that slack out, it wobbles less, and I get actually much better shots than I get with the little cheapo 5-megapixel that came with it. But it still does long flights, and it works quite well for just playing around with some video and trying to get used to that. This is my first drone. I've only flown it probably about a couple dozen times now, and just getting used to it. So it's been fun, and I'll put the video behind this of what I shoot right now. Okay, here's footage review of what I just shot. And good steady first shot. Just taking it straight up. There I am. There's the property. And the garden, and a little dropout up high there. So I throttle down and bring it back in, and then with the camera on, I let it come down too far, and even though I gave it full throttle, it did that. On to the next one here. Refocus. Oh, well, that's not the next one. Now I got water on my lens, so there's that fuzzy spot. But now I wanted to do a pass over a little group of trees close by, just to give it that perspective type of shot. And it didn't want to maintain the power. So it fell. So I go run out and go get it, flip it back over. So that's doing that. So yeah, this is Coolpix, Nikon. AW100. There you go, back in flight. I usually like to hit the record button when I take it down like that and start recording again, but I didn't on this one. And here it goes down again. So, video was, quality's pretty good off this camera.